Hey, what's going on everybody, and welcome back to another Python scripting tutorial. So today's video is going to be a quick tip. We're going to be looking at the correct naming conventions. So let's go ahead and jump over to the scripting workspace. Go over here and click scripting, change the workspace. And again, you can get rid of any of the panels that you don't need. So before I do anything else, I should mention that I'm using Blender 2.8, as you can see down here. So if you're using a future version of Blender, things may be different. So be sure to check out what version you're using. Anyway, so let's go ahead and load up a script. I'm going to go to templates, go to Python, and let's find the UI panel simple. So even using the template script, it's given us an incorrect naming convention, so we need to go ahead and change that. And you'd probably change this name anyway to something like main panel, which again is incorrect. Imagine you've got a whole bunch of different add-ons and they all had the same name as main panel, things wouldn't work. So that's one of the reasons why we need to use the correct naming conventions. Though that being said, if you hit run script, things would work as it should. I mean, we do need to copy this, go down here and paste this in, as we know we need to register and unregister. But if we run script, that naming convention would be fine. It would, you know, it'd probably kick up an error, but it wouldn't break anything. Again, the problem would be if you have multiple add-ons that had the exact same class name, then you would run into some trouble. So let's go ahead and get rid of this. So you might be wondering, what is the proper naming convention? It's really simple. First, you need the add-on name. So this would be the name of your add-on. So let's pretend we're working on the text tool add-on. So I would write text tool, but again, you would change this to be your add-on name. Then we can add an underscore. Since this is a panel type, we're going to type PT underscore, and then we can name this whatever we want. So I'm going to call this main underscore panel. And then make sure we select all of this, copy it, and again, paste it in your register and unregister section. And again, we can change the ID name. This is the identifier. So we can see this is the correct naming convention for a panel. And this is going to be the same whether it's an operator or a menu or a header. It'll just be a little bit different. So let's just make some space here. For example, if we wanted to use an operator, we'd type class, then the name of the add-on, which in my example, it's going to be text tool. And again, this is in capital letters. Then we're going to use an underscore, so we need to type OT for operator type, then underscore, and now we can just name the operator. So let's pretend this is an add underscore cube operator, then open and close parentheses, add a colon, then inside here we're going to type bpy dot types dot operator, and then let's just do one more for the menu. So let's type class, then the name of your add-on, then underscore, and since this is a menu, you probably already guessed, we're going to type MT for menu type, underscore, and then just type the name of your menu, so main underscore menu, and again, open and close parentheses, add a colon, bpy.types.menu, and then make sure you type it correctly. For example, here I didn't spell that correctly, so types. So as you can see, it's pretty simple for the naming conventions. If we break it down, we can see it's just your add-on name in capitals. Then there's an underscore. And then we need to add whatever type it is. So for example, if it's a panel type, menu type, header type, operator type, or a UI list, we'd add it here. And again, this is in capitals. Then underscore, and then now you just add the name of whatever the operator, menu, or header is. So we will just type main, and again, this is in lowercase, and we can separate this by another underscore. Another thing you can do is use camel caps. So we could say main panel, like that. And if you want some more information, there'll be a link in the description to our blog post. So go ahead and check that out. So hopefully this quick video helped. If it did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.